Steel Magnolias. Two sisters who love family, traditions, and all things Southern. We've got plenty of room at our table, so pull up a chair.
Hey, Lainey.
Hi, Laura Beth. Hope you had a good Labor Day weekend.
Yes, we are in full force now, baby.
It's football season.
That's right, or football time in Tennessee.
I know. We're going to be a little skewed anytime we talk football in the fall because we're Tennessee fans.
We can't help it, so I'm not going to apologize, but I am going to say we may be heavy on
orange. Yeah. We are going to be talking all schools today, though.
That's right.
We're talking all things college traditions and football
in
the South.
There's so much good.
And so, yeah, we do know a lot more about Tennessee versus any
other
school.
And more about SEC, I would say, as well.
Probably. Yeah, that's true.
I mean, we just do.
Yeah.
But we love our ACC fans.
Exactly.
And other conferences.
Yeah. So we talk about holding on to the good of the South. I am so excited to share some of these traditions today because they are holding on to the good of the South.
That's right. There's something so beautiful about tradition, isn't there?
Tradition!
That's right. Fiddler on the Roof. Yeah, there's just something that makes you think of years past and generations past and generations to come.
Yeah.
I mean, a beautiful thing.
The only time I had ever even been on the University of Tennessee's campus before showing up for orientation was for football games.
Yeah.
I never even went and did a tour before I, decided
I was... kind of had already been on campus.
Because I'd kind of been on campus, yeah. So, and that's the experience for a lot of people, that they came to campus via
a football game.
And then sometimes they end up going to school there.
Yeah.
So, anyway, well... We're going to have popcorn around like crazy today
because
we have a lot of teams.
Things that we love.
To cover. So let's just start with the powerhouse. Roll Tide, Alabama.
Oh, man. It's so hard to even say those words.
Well, we'll say that we're starting alphabetically. I don't know. We'll just start with them.
That's hilarious.
They are a phenomenal football team.
Domination.
Yeah.
I mean, there's no other way around it. It's domination.
So, of course, legendary coach Paul Bear Bryant is their claim to fame. And a tradition that I love that they do is he wore regularly a houndstooth fedora type hat.
That's right.
And even though their colors are crimson and white, oftentimes you see just
houndstooth all over the place.
Houndstooth.
That's right.
Which is kind of fun for the girls,
right? It's cool. It's a cool pattern.
Like you're styling your team colors, but you're in houndstooth. So.
Or you even see that in decor of the tailgate.
Oh,
or
for sure.
In rooms that people decorate that have, you know, their...
Yeah.
Their Alabama football pillows that are houndstooth with the big A on it or
that kind of thing. Black and white houndstooth everything is their way to pay homage to Bear Bryant.
I was going to say Sports Illustrated came out with a couple of lists just a couple weeks ago.
Okay.
And one of their lists was the... Well, there's a couple that I was going to mention. One list is best college traditions of all time. And one was biggest college rivalries of all time.
Ooh, okay.
So, anyway, I will be referencing both of those lists. But the Alabama-Auburn rivalry, also known as the Iron Bowl.
The Iron Bowl, yes.
Is considered the biggest college rivalry of all time by most lists.
Yeah.
But that made the number one slot.
That's real.
That's
I can see how they got that slot because that's a heated
rivalry. We have one family member that lives in Alabama and flies their UT flag amongst all of the Auburn, Alabama flags on homes throughout that state.
Yeah. Well, yeah, they're just like that, aren't they?
Well, and I think... In the South, you pick your team, and in a rivalry like that, it gets heated
sometimes. Yeah. Well, also, if you're on Alabama's campus on game day, you're going to see a lot of tailgating at the Quad, a 22-acre area that is a huge lawn party. The Million Dollar Band assembles at the library and plays toward the Quad and then moves into the stadium.
That's fun.
That would be a tradition that has been longstanding there amongst those that Roll Tide.
man, they've just had it. So it's been fun to be an Alabama fan for quite some time now, and their day will come, I guess, eventually.
Yeah,
or they're not such the powerhouse, but they've had it for a while. 17 national championships.
Yeah, they used to always play UT on my birthday weekend, or like my birthday week, you know. And so when I was in college, it was fun because it was a little closer of a rival. But
well, Tennessee was a powerhouse.
Now
it's
just tough
at that time.
It's just tough to have that late October birthday. Okay.
Well, I wasn't going to go in any alphabetical order or anything.
No,
there's
jump
all
around.
Different ones. But one that I love, a tradition that I love, is at Texas A&M.
Yeah.
They do the 12th man at Kyle Field.
Yes.
And it made the number 6 on the Sports Illustrated list of best traditions of all time. But anyway, I love that 12th man thing, just meaning that you, as the 12th man on the field, you know, make a difference.
That's cool.
I like that mindset.
That they include you.
Yeah.
That's cool. I like that a lot. Now, this was fun. We had a listener, Marianne, that is a huge Aggies fan, and she actually got in touch with me. She knew that we were going to be doing a college traditions episode.
Okay.
And thankfully, she did it before we had this finished, so I could include this piece, because this was really fun.
Oh, cool.
To include.
Thanks, Marianne.
Yeah, and I did not know this. So, her grandfather graduated from A&M, and then it was male and all military.
Okay.
And I guess her father, I think, went there as well. But, oh, yeah. And then her uncle and her and cousins. I mean, it's
okay. Family tradition.
Yes. They are diehard Aggies. Anyway, she did tell us if we ever go to an A&M game to make sure and go to midnight yell practice the night before.
Okay.
That basically... Yeah, that's a good way to take notes.
Is it pep rally kind of thing?
I think so.
Okay.
But every time A&M scores during a game, all the guys kiss their girls. So back when Marianne's grandfather was there, you know, and it was all male, all military school, girls were only allowed on campus for football games.
Okay.
So
this was a good excuse.
Since the military frowns upon public displays of affection, they had to come up with a way to kind of have a reason to kiss their date.
So cute.
And so that's how the tradition was born.
And it continued this.
Every time the Aggies score, all Aggies score. That's how they say it.
That's hilarious.
Anyway, and she said her grandparents are in their late, or when they were in their late 80s, that was when they were in their late 80s when they passed away. And every time that they went to a home game,
they still
her
did.
Her grandfather still kissed her Nana.
Precious. Oh, I love that.
Yeah. Thank you, Marianne, for sharing that with us. Well, at University of Arkansas, the Razorbacks, they do the Call of the Hog.
Yes.
So, like, one fan stands up, raises his arms in the air and fingers wiggling and begins the woo.
Oh, yeah.
And then every Arkansas fan is then participating in the Call of the Hog. So, it's like...
I think it's adorable, but I have to say, if I was a cheerleader, I would not want to put on a pig nose.
Well,
like, that's just embarrassing.
They wear a lot of, like, the head, like, the pig head.
Yeah.
It's just all sorts of headwear, and facial, things.
That would be a little awkward to me, but, you know, it is a cute tradition,
and
I definitely know it when I see it.
They fully embraced it. That's what I love about it.
That's right. That's a beautiful thing, right?
Yeah.
Well, South Carolina has a fun tradition. A couple things I wanted to mention about that. They have a tailgating area that includes 22 train cars that sit on an inactive railroad and provide, like, luxury food and drink that you can...
Are you serious?
That's
cool.
I've never seen that, but it sounds fun, and the pictures were cool that I saw. But they also have a pure white horse that carries in the Trojan Warrior. They call it the Traveler. And I think that's kind of fun.
Oh, that's cool.
Too.
I like that. I had not heard that. That's very cool. Well, if you were to go to LSU.
Oh, Lord. I would love to go. Is it Death Valley?
Go Tigers. Is that what they call it?
It's called Death Valley.
Yes, it is.
Okay.
So... Yeah, I have a book that I read from, and yeah, the Tigers rarely lose when they play at home. There's a reason they call their stadium Death Valley. Win or lose, festivities continue long into the night all across the state.
That is a party
capital
school.
City. I was
whether you're
say,
at Tulane or LSU, wherever you are down there in Louisiana, you're partying.
Yeah, and it's all like a microcosm of Bayou culture.
That's right.
So it's like a Mardi Gras party, frat party, family reunion.
Yeah, you're going to see lots of like jambalaya and gumbo and things like that if you're at a LSU tailgate.
Yeah. So, it's like, their band is the Golden Band from Tigerland. And, you know, by the time they march across campus, that they're playing, like, a jazzy pregame salute.
So cute.
Fans are in a frenzy. Yeah, it's just a party.
And in typical French tradition, their Go Tigers is spelled G-E-A-U-X,
X.
Not G-O.
Yeah. And then they're always saying, who dat?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So, yeah. I actually would like to go down there
yeah,
sometime,
that would
too.
Be a fun
it sounds very fun.
Visit. Well, we, you know, I'm not going any further until I talk about Tennessee.
All right.
So, Tennessee has such an impressive campus and tailgate.
They do.
But one thing that makes them super unique is that it's right on the Tennessee River.
Yep.
One of only a couple of schools in the nation that
yeah.
are on water like that. So they have what's called the Vol Navy.
Yes.
Very unique. Makes almost every list of top tailgates.
As it should.
As it should. Because it's like an all-day boating party.
Yeah.
People going from one boat to another. Some of them have hot tubs. Some of them have...
That's true.
You know, like there's music easily played on the different boats. And some people go into the game. Some people don't. They just stay on the boat
right,
party.
Yeah.
But the Vol Navy is very unique. Hundreds, I think there's a couple hundred boats typically on a Saturday that
yeah.
come up there and dock just for
yeah.
for game day.
Yeah. And then the Vol Walk would
oh.
be a very important tradition to mention, where the team and coaches and staff make their pilgrimage from usually around the Circle Park area where the statue torchbearer is, all the way down into the stadium.
And they're dressed in their, like,
they're in their suits.
Jacket.
Yeah, they're
tie.
Not dressed out in their uniforms
colors
at
yet.
That time. But the Pride of the Southland marching band.
Which is spectacular.
Yeah, yeah. And Smokey, mascot. Everybody's there. It's like a full-on parade. It looks like a homecoming parade, but this happens every single home game.
And typically it's the current team, but like I know just a couple years ago, Peyton and his son
yeah.
walked with the team.
Yeah.
Peyton being Manning.
Peyton Manning.
Yeah, yeah. So.
And I would say like our stadium size, 107,000 seats is usually with the number that is quoted.
I think
quoted.
They took
it's,
some out
it's
to do boxes now. Anyway.
But it is wild to see the way, because of the way the stadium sits, you know, you kind of do have this convergence onto the stadium.
Yeah.
And you get to actually appreciate the massive amount of people there just because of the way it kind of dips down
and
a little
bit. And the orange
bit.
Shows up like no other.
Yeah.
And the checkerboard end zones. But one thing I love is actually it started under Doug Dickey in 1964. The Pride of the Southland marching band is doing their little thing out on the field.
Pre-game. Yeah.
And they come in and then at one point they split and make this big T.
Yes.
Oh, this makes me have chills.
The power T. Yeah.
That they call the power T. Doug Dickey had put that on the helmet for the first time.
Okay.
In 1964. And that's when that started.
Okay.
To come through the T. The team runs through.
Okay.
And it's so sweet.
Smokey, our blue tick hound dog. He is always the first out of the team.
Yes.
Always.
So
the real one, not the
right.
mascot.
Not the mascot dog,
yeah.
but the real
yeah.
dog. Which is taken care of by the AGRs, always.
Exactly.
That fraternity has care of Smokey. Anyway, great traditions there.
Fantastic. Okay.
I'll let you go next.
I'll go next. So, Auburn, War Eagle.
Wow.
This is pretty... wonderful. And I actually have been to an Auburn game, and I guess I got there a few minutes too late before kickoff, so I did not get to appreciate this. But they actually have a majestic golden eagle that leaps off of a balcony.
It's amazing.
And circles the stadium, and of course, fans begin chanting, "War Eagle!"
Yeah.
Yeah, so then the eagle lands midfield, and it's game time.
It's amazing.
And, yeah, that's, and then, so that's the, of course, you know, getting the game started. And then after the game,
If there's a win,
everybody runs over to the oldest entrance of campus, which is Toomer's Corner. And they roll the trees.
Now,
which I think it's so silly because it's like,
but it's cool looking and fun and harmless.
Go do something that's like not a big cleanup. Like you usually roll people that you don't like.
That's true.
Anyway,
but the beauty of rolling is it is harmless to a tree. I mean, it's just gonna finally come off.
Right.
What is not harmless to a tree is to poison it, and that is such a horrific thing that happened in 2011.
Oh my gosh. I didn't think I knew about this.
This was such a huge deal. This Alabama fan was later arrested for poisoning the Toomer's Corner oaks that later had to be replanted because
those are the trees
them.
That they roll. Yeah,
that's
those
right.
are the, oh my gosh.
So if you want to know more about the depth of hatred that can come from college football, I'm going to recommend another podcast to listen to. There's a podcast called Mobituaries with Mo Rocca.
Okay.
And he did an episode called Death of a Tree, Roots of a Rivalry. And he tells the story of the poisoning of the Toomer's Corner oaks and actually even has some audio from the man who was arrested who did it. So if you have any interest in hearing about more about that story, it's actually a pretty good telling of the story.
Okay. Maybe I can put a link in our show notes.
Okay. Anyway, that was a big deal. But the Toomer's Corner rolling also made the Sports Illustrated list of best college traditions. That came in at number 5.
Oh, my gosh. Wow.
So interesting,
right?
I have
not heard the tree story. That's crazy.
Well, Clemson... in the Atlantic Coast Conference, great college town. I went and visited Clemson, and it is just beautiful college town.
Did you seriously consider going there?
Not seriously consider, but I would say I was so impressed with the campus. And I love when a college town is kind of all there is the college.
Like
all the restaurants had things about, you know, welcome back students and that kind of thing.
Yeah.
Like, it's just cool when that's the focus of the town, and that's the case there at Clemson. But they have a tradition where the team runs in and rubs Howard's Rock as they're coming in.
Okay.
That's supposed to, you know, bring good luck to the game. So, anyway, that is an old tradition and was also on Sports Illustrated list at number 2.
Hey!
So...
Wow.
There you go.
Well, I will jump to Mississippi State University and tell you a tale of the cowbell that they are so proud of. So the school legend says that fans adopted the tradition in the 1930s after a Jersey cow wearing a bell around her neck wandered onto the field.
No way.
During the Mississippi State versus Ole Miss game.
Big rivalry.
And Mississippi State won big time.
Okay, so that...
They beat their arch rivals, and the cowbell became a good luck charm.
That's so hilarious.
You will definitely see cowbells, or a cowbell clanking.
Well, that's way long before the funny More Cowbell...
It is.
...Saturday Night Live skit, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah. So that's I just feel like that's a really unique tradition, but...
And even the birthing of it's hilarious.
I love it. Yeah.
Well, that actually made the Sports Illustrated list at number 8 as best college traditions. But it was also the Mississippi State Ole Miss game is listed as number 8 of the biggest rivalries in college football. It says arguably the ugliest, nastiest series in all of college football. In Mississippi, there is Christmas, Easter, and Egg Bowl Day.
Oh, my gosh.
The Egg Bowl. Not sure where that came from, but...
Well, a cowbell is stinking loud, you know? So when you think about one times thousands or hundreds, you know, like...
Yeah.
So there's actually cowbell etiquette that they have.
No.
Like a 2010 conference came up with, because it was getting out of hand.
Okay. I can see that, especially with people who've had some alcohol.
Yeah. So conference, I don't know, president's athletic director, somebody, they came up with the cowbell clause. No joke. So anyway, fans can shake their bells only at appropriate times. And I don't know what those appropriate times are, but I know there's a website, respectthebell.com.
No way.
Yeah. So you probably need to check that out before you go to a game.
That's hilarious.
With your cowbell.
Well, there's lots of different hand motions that became popular with different traditions.
Yeah.
I think mostly of the one that rubs me the most wrong would be the gator chomp.
That's so true.
It's in Florida.
So invasive.
At the swamp. Well, they do it everywhere. No matter where they're playing, they gator chomp.
I think even pro players that were came from the University of Florida still chomp when they're on their pro fields.
Yeah, maybe it's like fresh as their first year.
Yeah.
Anyway, and then, of course, Texas has the hook'em horns.
Yes, that's true.
Which is cute.
That's cute. And seems a little more tasteful for some reason.
And just speaking of Texas, I was thinking whether you're at Texas A&M or Texas, which, by the way, both big college rivalries. In fact, Texas is in two of the top 10 rivalries. They're number 3, Texas versus Oklahoma on that Sports Illustrated list. And number 10 was Texas A&M. So those are
big
rivalries.
Yeah.
But I was just going to say, from a tailgating perspective, lots of good brisket at Texas tailgates.
Heck,
so you would probably
yes.
see that at either school's tailgate.
Yeah. That makes sense.
Love that Texas brisket.
Well, since we've mentioned the gator chomp, I will mention about the Florida Gators that their stadium is one that every visiting team ever
is scared to go
avoids
into.
Like the plague. Yeah, it's a very difficult place to play. It's hot. It's humid. And the Gators, of course, are well-versed and used to practicing all summer long.
Like that.
In that kind of heat, and a lot of these other teams, even though they're southern teams, aren't used to that level.
That's true.
The first 32 rows of their stadium is actually below sea level. So, I mean, it is they call it the swamp.
Right. And so I've been to a game there.
Was it crazy loud?
It's so crazy loud. And part of it is because of the shape of it, the way it's real steep.
Yeah.
And I didn't know the below sea level thing.
Yeah.
But it's super hard for the players on the field to hear.
I'm sure.
And so Florida plays that up to their advantage.
Yeah.
And they're super quiet when their team is talking, and they're super loud when the opposing team is trying to come up with a play.
Yeah. So Steve Spurrier, their coach, actually during the time that I was in college at Tennessee, is the one that began referring to the stadium as the Swamp.
Okay.
So it's been around for...
That's not that low. That's not that old.
No, but...
In lieu of some of these traditions.
That's true. Yeah. Yeah, I know. I meant to actually say that up front. These schools were founded in, like, sometimes even the late 1700s, early
1800s. Yeah.
So some of these traditions have been around for 200 plus years.
That's amazing.
That is amazing.
Truly.
Okay. That's all the Gators get.
That's hilarious. Well... another big Florida school for football is Florida State.
Yeah.
The Seminoles. And under Bobby Bowden in 1977, they started having the chief ride in on horseback with his flaming spear. So that's a big tradition for them, is when the chief comes in. And they had, under Bobby Bowden, very good football years. He was quite the powerhouse.
Yeah, he was.
So, anyway, that's all I was going to say about Florida State.
Yeah.
But,
well, we would be remiss to not mention the school that oftentimes gets voted number one tailgate, which is Ole Miss.
The Grove.
Hotty Toddy, the Grove. I know this is on your list of places that you would love to see. I read a quote once that said, Ole Miss is to tailgating what Bach is to music.
No.
Quite simply, the best.
That's hilarious.
It's a little strong.
I had a cute quote, too. They have a saying down at Ole Miss, we may not win every game, but we never lose a party.
All right.
So they do take their partying seriously.
Yeah.
Yeah, they usually make most lists as the number one tailgate.
Yeah, yeah. So their colors are pretty. It's like a navy blue and a cardinal red. And, you know, you often see really bright white tents, as we've mentioned on our tailgating episode, with chandeliers and just
bring out heirloom
silver, family china, you know.
It's quite fancy.
But also, you know, girls wearing Prada and Jimmy Choo shoes and
two football games. That's so foreign to me.
Yeah. So,
that's funny.
Anyway, I would say probably the Grove is somewhere everybody needs to at least visit at one point, but yeah.
That would be a fun tailgate to hit.
Because they've never lost a party.
That's right.
Yeah.
Well, let's see. What next? I had the Mississippi State Cowbells as well, but how about Oklahoma?
Yeah.
They are the Sooners, and they have the Sooner Schooner. So this was actually number one on Sports Illustrated's Best Traditions list.
Okay.
And it's just this old covered wagon that they come in on.
Yeah.
Pulled by horse, so... That's one of their big traditions. Oklahoma, obviously really good in football over time. Again, I mentioned the number three Texas versus Oklahoma rivalry, the Red River rivalry.
Mm-hmm.
And they're Big 12, I think.
Okay.
So, anyway, that's a powerhouse football school.
Yeah. Yeah, it is. I will segue to the Georgia Bulldogs.
Okay.
They have an English Bulldog, which is their mascot, named UGA, UGA, University of Georgia.
Yeah.
That's what that stands for. But they have a chapel bell that rings on campus when
I've
they win.
This.
It's a long-standing tradition. So I haven't been on their campus myself.
Well,
but
Athens is another cool college town.
Yes, it is.
Great music scene.
I was going to say, that's from where a lot of bands came from.
R.E.M. Mm-hmm. And playing the 40 Watt Club there.
Yes.
Is a great music venue to visit. But
their fans are improving a little bit. They used to be kind of ugly. I guess
every
team
school
you could
has
say
that.
I should probably not say that. Yeah.
Yeah. That's
every team
depends
has its
on
ugly
what
fans.
Drunk people you ran into.
That's
but
true.
I would say they did kind of have a reputation of being a little rough. But you know, they've had some powerhouse football years too.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I think back to when I like in the '80s, they were so good.
Yeah.
Georgia was so good. So also in Georgia, we have Georgia Tech.
Oh, yeah.
Right there in the middle of Atlanta.
Yeah.
And they have a tradition that is they come in on the Ramblin' Wreck is what it's called. It's a 1930 Ford Model A sports coupe.
Oh.
And for years, they've come in on this. Well, I'm saying they come in. I think it's just a couple of the like cheerleaders.
Okay.
Ride in on this Ramblin' Wreck. But that's a popular tradition, and I think that even may have made some list of great top traditions. And so anyhow, Georgia Tech.
That's cool.
Yeah.
I will mention Kentucky Wildcats up in the beautiful Lexington, Kentucky area. So of course they're going to have,
they're more basketball powerhouse.
Yeah.
But they participate.
They'll have good bourbon at their tailgate for sure. They do a call to post, just like you would hear at the Kentucky Derby or other horse races, like over at Keeneland. So just a nod to the horse racing that comes from that area. That's played pregame, and
that's
awesome. Is, you know, the segue into the game itself. But, you know, that would be a pretty one to go to a game if you were also going to be able to do other things up there.
Absolutely.
That weekend, right?
Just, that's right.
Visits to distilleries and things. But yeah, the Go Big Blue, the Kentucky Wildcats.
I didn't have any other specific schools I was going to mention traditions, though. I mean, there's so many schools that have great traditions. I mean, yeah, there's so many. I think we could go on and on. But I was going to just talk about, we've mentioned before on another episode, but Thanksgiving weekend, there's a lot of the big rivalry games.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And many of them are close to home. You know, we were talking about if they're in-state rivalries, you're not going to be too far away from being with family if it's Thanksgiving weekend.
Yeah.
But one that's quite famous is on neutral ground, and that is the Florida-Georgia game.
Yeah.
And it's always played in Jacksonville.
Okay.
And they call it the world's largest cocktail party.
Ha, ha, ha. Yeah.
So,
yeah.
Very
yeah.
cute
yeah.
tradition, big rivalry, and that's kind of a fun tradition I wanted to mention.
Yeah. Oh, we got to mention Missouri.
Ah, yes.
So I forget
that they're Southern.
I know, but I do.
They're now in the SEC conference. I don't think of that as Southern, but we'll keep going.
So yeah, because they're Columbia, Missouri. But so Mizzou is what you would hear them called. But they have a tradition at, I don't know how you say their field, Faro Field.
Okay.
But they call it the zoo, like Z-O-U.
Okay. Okay.
Anyway, but they say, you know, one could argue every day, every game day is homecoming because before the season starts, freshmen whitewash the big M that marks the north end zone and tailgates featuring mouthwatering Kansas City or St. Louis style barbecue and the thousands that greet the Fighting Tigers as they make their way to the stadium before a game is a sight to see. So, you know, once a Tiger, always a Tiger. So the Bengal Tiger is their mascot.
That's cute.
I didn't want to not mention them because they are now in the SEC.
Well, like we said, we're heavy on SEC because that's what we're more familiar with and what we grew up visiting some of those campuses. But there are many other great football rivalries, great college traditions. You know, even in the ACC, the Atlantic Coast Conference, other schools are North Carolina State, University of Louisville, UNC Chapel Hill, which is a huge basketball school. Virginia Tech, which is special in, well, it's a gorgeous campus, but it has both military and civilians together in one campus. I think that's the only campus that's
right.
like that.
I forgot about that.
You have, I don't really necessarily think of, we've mentioned before, Miami seems like it's not the South. It's like its own beast.
It is. It's technically different.
Technically it's in the South by location. And then you have Duke and Wake Forest over in North Carolina. Great schools that I'm sure have great traditions, too. They're just not necessarily football powerhouses.
Yeah.
More basketball, especially Duke. But anyway, did you have any others?
Right in our hometown, we have to say something about Vanderbilt.
Oh, Vanderbilt.
They're getting better, too.
Well, yeah, you know, I didn't used to think of that as a rivalry.
Right. Yeah.
But because Tennessee's had a rough go,
yeah,
it's become a little bit more of a rivalry. But they do quite the fancy tailgating as well.
They do. They're the Commodores. They bear the name Commodore from Cornelius Vanderbilt, the rail and shipping, whatever you want to call it, powerhouse.
Multimillionaire.
Multimillionaire, yeah. Who, you know, he provided the seed money to start the school. But they have the sound of the horns, ship horn that signals the Commodores.
And they are anchor down.
Yeah.
That's what their big famous saying.
Yeah. So they are, since they're situated right in the city, I think like some of the college town, like we've described on some of these other campuses, gets a little lost over at Vanderbilt. But
beautiful campus, though.
It is beautiful.
Well, and speaking of anchors, this is not Southern, but I have to say, pretty high up on my list of bucket list football experiences is I want to go to the Army-Navy game someday.
Oh, yeah.
Navy sings the anchors away is their song. But that's a big rivalry and quite the... I mean, even just watching it on TV is exciting to me.
Yeah.
Just seeing the passion behind that rivalry,
yeah,
the Army versus Navy. But That's on my list, yeah. Even though it's not Southern. That's yeah. quite the tradition.
Well, we didn't even dive into, like, fight songs and some of the history and just the lyrics of some of these schools that, you know, sing every single game multiple times a game.
I will say, I know we said we're heavy on Tennessee. Rocky Top is known as one of the more famous
yeah.
fight songs.
School songs, yeah, yeah. Yeah, so...
And I have a funny story to share.
What?
I'm going to say on air. But one time, Laura Beth and I... this is... We have a lot of funny memories.
No idea where this is going.
Lots of funny memories. But we decided after watching the movie Wedding Crashers that that would be a fun thing to do sometime.
Oh, yeah.
Would be to crash a wedding. Well, I'm going to say it on air. Your eyes look big.
Oh, now I know where you're going. Okay.
We went and attended a wedding that we were invited to. But because we were already dressed up and we saw another wedding was happening, we decided that would be the night we would be wedding crashers.
Yes, pop into another wedding reception.
So we popped in and signed the guest book. Mm-hmm. Ate the cake and danced to Rocky Top
That's
on
right.
the dance floor before leaving. And it was so much fun.
Because
at a wedding,
fun.
You know, not everybody knows everybody.
Yeah.
You've got only, you know, lots of new people, meeting new people. And so we just were able to slip in, do our thing, slip out.
They had a killer
fancy
shrimp cocktail
reception.
Ice sculpture.
Yes, yeah. It was a fun one to,
that was
to
a
crash.
Good one. But yes, we felt at home when they started
when they
playing
Rocky
Top.
And we were able to dance on the dance floor. It felt just wonderful.
That's so awesome. Oh my gosh. Well, this has given me a little bit more appreciation for some of the different campuses. And it just makes me even more proud to be from the Southerner. So.
I know.
Hopefully you guys will get a chance to check out a game at somewhere in the South this season, because as we've already laid out, there is much fun to be had even off the field. So
that's right.
Anyway, that's going to do it for this episode, and we hope you guys have a great week. We'll see you here next time.
Bye, y'all.